Which I've got only two bookmarks left for it because I needed them. Yeah, spent quite a while out there mapping the whole highway.
Yeah, that looks good. Yeah, so that's something I'll probably be interested in doing, I think.
Alright, cool.
Anyway, just sort of check in before I went. I'll catch us when you get back.
Yeah, hopefully you should be back sometime tomorrow. I've got a bit of stuff to do during the day for finalising my work stuff. And then free man for a bit.
Yep, alright. See you later.
See you.
Get you. See you, Sparrows.
We need a fleet carrier to get to this other location I've got.
You do.
Looks like it. Is that a dwarf? Yeah. Yeah, it's like right above the galactic plane.
Oh, okay. And
there ain't any stars.
Getting a good view from up there, eh? Or down there?
I imagine you would. It's the what's the nebula called? Box Nebula.
I'll come over and have. You're still screaming. I'll come over and have a look.
Yeah, I think it's a neutron star. Wolf rat. Yeah, that would be a use a fleet carrier to get there and back.
So where's the galactic plane?
Just zoom out.
Oh wow, you're right up there, aren't you? Wow.
No, no, I'm not up there. I'm here.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah, I was looking at you.
Trying to get to there.
Yep.
Yeah. No, I don't think I'll be doing that one. So I guess it's back to the fleet carrier. Oh no, to that one first. And then continue on home. That'll be most of the stuff in the codex.
Okay.
Or for this section anyway.
Yep.
Jump 64 jumps. Ouch.
So what was that rift you guys were talking about before?
Formidine Rift.
Where's that?
Southwest of Salt.
So if you're in the bubble looking back towards Sage A, that's southwest, is it?
Yeah, so Beagle points north.
Yeah. Okay. Is that the name of the system, is it?
The region.
Oh, okay, yep.
It's stuff to do with the Drew Wager books, premonition and reclamation.
Okay. One of the other things I wanted to do in this game was go right around the outer edge of the galaxy. Do a big full loop.
Yeah, one day I might do that.
Maybe when I get my carrier I'll do it. And you probably won't see me for 2 years back in the bubble then.
That's entirely doable.
Yeah, I was saying plenty of people, well, plenty of markers around the map that people have done it. You know, the lines that you see on ADSM and all that.
System scan complete.
Ooh. Is that an Earth-like? Ah, hate that.
Rocky ice world?
Yep.
Right
Screw
on the border.
System, I'm moving on.
Right on the border again?
Yep.
Yep. I won that last night. I reckon that was done intentionally.
Yeah, get your hopes up. Yeah.
Yep, that's exactly what I was going to say. Ah, made you look.
Comply. Surface scan by 50%. Surface scan complete.
Oh, hello.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
Oh, how you do?
Very good.
Oh, fuck.
Didn't think we were going to see you tonight.
I'm kind of reworking my base in Satisfactory. It's becoming a real nightmare.
Oh, okay.
It's like, oh, I need to rebuild this, but I need all these parts, so I need to build more mess to generate more parts, and delete it, delete it. It's just like, oh, God.
Yeah, I need to stay away from a game like that. I did that enough in bloody Kerbal.
Because apparently the new update is adding a gas and a whole bunch of other stuff. It's going to be interesting when that comes out. I think it's March or something.
But it's still early access, isn't it?
Yeah. I opened up Cyberpunk before and I'm like, it has another update in like a month. I was like, yeah, I'm just going to close that now.
Yeah. That's pretty much what I'm waiting for. Just a few fixes here and there.
But are doing any more updates or they're just...
There's supposed to be one coming January? Maybe this week or next week, but yeah, who knows.
I would assume more updates are coming. They've just prioritized the low-hanging fruit early on.
Yes, I dare say they're in full-blown damage control by now.
Yeah, there's more shit.
Even the Polish government's getting involved.
Yeah. Well, Elite Dangerous did not like that. Counted an error, that's...
Oh.
I haven't seen one of those in a long time.
I had one on the alt account last night when I was doing the bubble run. Did the first jump and got Scarlet Crate. Closed it down, opened it back up. And the launcher was saying the server was offline, but it wasn't. So, log in, log out a few times, and then finally decided to start working. Like,
Maybe it's not liking my undervolt on the CPU. But I've been playing games all fucking for a while now.
Yeah.
Come your tits. I got it past 5 gigahertz on like 4 of my cores, so. Over 5 gigahertz, sorry. It was like almost 5.1, but it's just the BIOS version I'm using, and it's just...
Still not handling the current correctly?
It's just fucked. It's in beta, so... I've tried three different beta versions, and yeah... The latest one seems to be... the best at the moment. We'll find out.
No, I'm hanging out for this NVIDIA update in February. Finally enable bar.
You know it's only for 3060s, right?
Is it? Oh. That's not fair.
I didn't think they were adding...
What is that, an enable?
SAM. Well, it's called... It's bar for NVIDIA, but yeah.
What's that do?
It pretty much gives direct access to your VRAM.
Oh, okay.
So instead of like chunks, it's complete access.
Yeah.
Some games you see decreased performance, and some games you see, what is it, like 5-10%?
It's only for
It's not really. It's not really decreased performance. It's just marginal.
Yeah.
Maybe one or two frames here and there, but some games do see an improvement.
Okay.
But that's could get better over time.
Yeah, it's pretty much the same as DLSS.
Well, it's all still in beta at the moment, so. I just got a message from a friend. He's got a... What was he looking at? 6900 XT and a 5950X. So you can't just go away and leave me alone. He's like, no, it's for a build. I'm like, oh, thank God. he paid an arm and a leg for him, but yeah, he's still making money off it, so. Not off the CPU. The graphics card he is, but the CPU's definitely not.
I'm still on my original CPU and motherboard that I bought when I first built my computer up. The Asus Maximus 5 Extreme motherboard with
X470. Fuck you doing all the way out there, Taurus.
I was doing some codec stuff, and then the last one I was about to go to, I can't get there. I need a fleet carrier to jump me there. It's a little bit too high.
Around where Square Eyes is where that, what was it? Where was the post? It was Colonia or Bust, wasn't it? Yeah, where's the system? I think it's near Square Eyes. Oh, he's already passed it.
I mean,
You've already passed it. You would literally have to turn around and...
What system is that?
It's with the Void Hearts in it.
Oh, that one with the photo. There's a big field of them. Yeah, that was cool.
It's about 16,000 light years away from Colonia, and it's just over 20 from the bubble.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
So if you were near Sad J, you could have flown out there then.
No, I'm not turning around back. Stuff that.
Yeah.
I want to get back to the bubble, man. Stop distracting me.
Oh, is it going to be an Earth-like or a fucking rocky ice world again?
Rocky.
Earth-like.
Fuck, how many jumps out are we at?
We're at the halfway point now. Oh, many a world.
Still over, I think I bet you over 100 jumps. 110. Yeah, no, thank you.
Yeah, I need to get back, put some more fuel in. Probably got enough for another maybe 3 jumps.
Invite me to your crew. I don't want to go anywhere. And I don't really want to go back into Satisfactory, so. See how well it works, eh?
It's generally fine as long as you don't launch the fighters. Because that kind of breaks them and then breaks your fighter bay.
Yeah. Okay. Seems to be working. Oh no, I can use camera mode. Nice.
Of course it's behind the bloody sun.
I don't know if that's the galactic dust or actual nebula.
Like world, yay!
Nice.
So I'm gonna have to go map that shit. Honk.
Didn't know I can do that. That is too. Aww. You kicked me out of it.
Kick you out of it?
You started accelerating.
Ah. You should be able to use the probes as well, I think.
I don't think so.
DSS is Opticrew, yes.
No, not that those. That's the. I can use that, the FSS. But. Okay. I don't know what your fucking key bindings are. They set up for me. Disabled, in use by another crew.
How do I change it?
There we go. So it's number one.
Ooh, it's even got a different icon when you're doing that. I've never seen that icon before.
Do what? I can't use it. It's
out of range. Now I'm moving too fast. Should be able to now.
Oh, it's not giving me anything.
So multi-crew gunner is on full.
It's not even, you know, when you switch between
fire groups.
Your fire orders are A, B, and C, whatever it is you got set up to. It doesn't tell me what I'm in. I can hear the noise that it's doing something. I'm in the gunner role, so. Interesting.
How else you would set it up? Oh, that's doing something.
Yeah, I may have just fucked with your. Just keep giving me
Q.
I don't know. What is Q?
I've never seen Q before.
I've never. Yeah, you can have it back on one.
You must be for yourself then.
Yeah, but it's not doing anything.
Because there were the different colors for the first and second fire. Not letter Q.
Yeah, primary fire. Is that a Q or a U for primary and secondary fire? Primary utility and secondary utility.
Like a Q from my end.
System scan complete. Oh fuck! I forgot how to change it now.
Yeah, that's on primary.
Yeah, but what is the primary fire key?
Mash the keys until you get a hit.
That does combat mode. Oh, that's FSS. No hostiles in range. I don't want to. Oh, good. That didn't work.
No, it should reset once you've left the crew anyway.
Warning, self-targeting. I calmed your tits. Nah. Oh, what the fuck is this?
That was a different icon.
I just pressed tab.
That's gunner mode.
Oh, wicked. Alright.
And you can zoom around and shoot things if you have turrets and so on.
Did not know you can do that. Alright, let's switch this back to number one and see if... There we go!
There it goes.
So I gotta press tab, then use the normal fire groups.
Nice.
So you have to be gunner roll and press tab. Then you just got your 1 and 2, whatever you got. Interesting. Super cruise assist just activated. That wasn't me.
Shouldn't have deactivated. There's a ammonia world in here as well.
Looks to your right. Yeah, it doesn't move.
It does. Oh, when I actually look now.
Not for me. I don't see you looking at me.
See you wiping your mouth. Complete. See my neck hole. There's no head.
Should be watching a hardware monitor, trying to figure out what my best cores are at the moment, so I can overclock my best cores and yeah.
You can like prioritize cores on it.
Yeah, it's a new core optimizer they added into PBO2, the precision boost over air 2. So currently I'm running I think it's 150 megahertz overclock with I think it's negative 15 curve optimizer, which is an undervolt.
Yeah.
The RAM, I am waiting for what's it called? Like Zen timings or some shit. It's a calculator you use to set up all your timings and shit for your RAM.
Yeah, okay. That just for AMD?
No, you can do it on Intel as well. I don't think Intel really gives a shit. You can get away with using the XMP profiles. You can on AMD, but it's better to do a manual timing.
Just a more fine tuning than
yeah,
the defaults.
Yeah.
Oh, we can probe at the same time.
Really?
Yep.
That's I put out four good. Probes. I don't see yours firing.
Oop. Anyway, guys, I have a few minutes.
There goes one. Now you've just ruined it.
That's nine.
System scan complete. I'm gonna need one more. Then you put it in a useless spot.
Shush. Yeah, got a percent.
Hopefully this is enough.
Yeah, it should be. Still well within the efficiency. Nice. I've been noticing a weird thing with the carrier jumps as well, with the galactic background.
Mm-hmm.
When you get... I noticed it on the way in as well, and again on the way back, where after a few jumps, the core doesn't render quite properly. and it's like this big yellowy red void.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
A bit bright?
It's just different, being in this seat. These anacondas are meant to be so old, why don't they have meant to be used as well? Need more wear and tear on the inside. More rustic look.
Yeah, we've got those wires hanging down, that's about it.
Yeah.
But if you think about it, like, they've taken the same sort of approach as like a B-51 bomber, where they're still running the same airframe after almost 100 years now. And they just completely gut them and update them each iteration.
Put it like that, but why leave the exposed wires?
Last minute job. Like, oh shit, we've got to route these through. Just put them over the top.
Stuff them out of the way. Try and hide them.
Six jumps.
To where?
Bit behind the carrier. And then catch up with the carrier from there. Just trying to nab those last few codex entries. But one of them was back near Colonia. They're like, yeah, nah, I'm not going to do that.
See, I don't get the deceleration when you jump out. It's just literally there. Hello. There's a star.
Oof, 33 bodies.
Frameshift drive charging. There's an ammonia ward in here by the looks of it.
Yeah.
Found it. I should be able to target it. Target it for you.
No, I think. Can you FSS as well?
I'm FSSing it right now. Is the number changing?
Yep. Bookmark these systems so when the data gets sold, see if both our names go on there.
I like doubt it.
So I'm not sure if we're gonna be still in the same session when you sell it.
Frameshift drive charging. Possibly.
Yeah, with me cat.
But yeah, there is an ammonia ward in here.
Where is it?
I think we're at number 4. Yeah, number 4.
Oh, yeah, there it is.
Yeah, unavailable for crew. Frameshift drive charging. The question is, if I map it, then you hand it in, who gets the data?
That's what technically, I'm curious to find out.
Technically, I'm in a telepresence. So I'm not a real person.
I'll book marking them anyway, so when I do so, I can look back and go, hey, it's either both of us or one of us. Oh shit, that's right, it's bin night. I'm gonna take the fucking bins up.
Fucking, we had, what is it, roadside collection at the moment? So we had all these people, like, showing up between, like, 1 and 3 o'clock in the morning.
For fucking rummaging.
And I'm hearing the dogs barking. Like, we don't have anything at the front, it's just our neighbours. So, I think it was, like, 3 o'clock, like, the fourth car, I went out there with a fucking torch, shined it in this guy's face, and I told him to get fucked. Just fuck off.
Yeah, do it fucking daylight if you're gonna rummage. Yeah.
Like I said to him, if you're doing it at night, you have a guilty conscience, so do it during the fucking day, you dumb shit. No one's gonna care if you take their fucking rubbish.
Yeah.
I just walked away and went to bed.
Yeah, it was a couple of years ago, City of Armadale brought a thing in where, yeah, we've got the roadside collection, but you're only allowed to put it out like the day or so before. Because people used to put them out like the week before,
and there'd just be
shit everywhere. Because guns would go through the piles, spill it out into the road, and it'd get blown around. And by the time they come to collect it, it's just shit everywhere.
You're not meant to have that kind of rubbish out.
You know what they've done over here in Victoria with hard rubbish collection?
Hmm?
But they've done a similar thing where you put your rubbish out the day before hard rubbish collection day. But they made it against the law for people to go and rummage through other people's junk. They said once it's out on the nature strip, it belongs to the council.
Not going to stop many people, though.
No. I think they're just trying to scare people or some shit. I don't know. But, yeah, it doesn't stop anyone from doing shit, really. Especially in my little town, people are always doing it. You know, that if I leave stuff out on the front nature strip all the time, then it's you look the next day and it's gone.
And the neighbor put out an air compressor. And the only thing that's fucked with it is actual some of the seals are broken in it.
Okay.
Like that's like $10-$15 to fix that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's in better condition than what ours is, man. Jesus.
Yeah, because decent ones aren't cheap, brand new.
Yeah, I remember the old, when Dad used to do interstate and shit, we had, what are you doing to this poor planet?
Fucked up for the start. But, oh no, yeah.
What is it, the air compressors for your trucks and shit, so they're massive tanks, massive hoses, oh, I miss that. So you put on a respirator and you don't even need to, sweep the floor, you just get this big hose out, just blast the whole shit out.
Yeah.
You just come out and you just, oh, yep. Really, you have to go behind?
Yeah, fucked it. It's one of the things I like about the surface scanners, it doesn't matter what orientation your ship is.
The field of view you get in the gunner mode is pretty cool.
Was it more like a third person view?
Yeah. Be interesting to see the type 10 or something with all gimbaled weapons.
Might have to set a proper multi-crew ship up then.
Yeah, but the gimbaled weapons are just less powerful, so...
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I've got a whole bunch of engineered turrets in storage. Back from the early day of playing the game.
I already got rid of all mine.
And the only reason I didn't get rid of them yet is because they're engineering on them, and they'd all be legacy.
Gee, Elite Dangerous doesn't want to push my CPU below past 4.5. But my idle temps are a lot better now.
Just running a bit more stable?
Just when I'm undervolting it, so not putting as much voltage into the CPU. Turns out the RAM I'm using, the chips, what is it, SK Hynix or some chip? Apparently they're... what's the word? Not really the best. They're alright, but a Samsung B die or something is the considered good. Pretty much the RAM kit that costs like $100 more than what I was using, than what we're using, uses the better dies.
Okay.
So I can get a more tighter timings on it. What I'm looking at the moment is like your 4-5,000 megahertz RAM and shit. And what you can do is you can just downclock it to get tighter timings.
Okay, yeah, because more play across the chips.
Yeah, more expensive though, and they don't do fucking 16 gig DIMMs. So I'd have to go back to like 4x8, and I'd be locked in at 32 gig. Which I don't want that. So that Samsung's removing headphones and power adapters from their lineup soon.
Following Apple?
Yeah.
What is that?
Less waste.
And yet they make phones to last only a couple of years.
Phones last for a lot longer.
Mine
it's
do.
Just people just mistreat them and
yep,
yeah.
Don't know how to look after them. My S8 still really good. There's no damage on it.
I had
if I take it out of the case and take the screen protector off, it looks brand new.
Yeah.
Just gotta look after it.
Well, I beg to differ because I had an S6 Edge and I bought it brand new and I've looked after it, never thrown it or anything. And the speakers have all gone on it, the microphone's gone on it, so when I try and talk into it, it's coming through all crackly and that to everyone else. And when I put them on loudspeaker, they can't even hear me. And that's... So that's that phone's.
But like, how old?
It's only 2 or 3 years old.
S6.
Yeah, S6.
How'd be older than that?
No, I bought it brand new, so I've had it for like 2 or 3 years. I know they're about 4 years old or something. I think.
Five.
Yeah, it'd be about that. It's my S8. I've had for over 3 years now.
Fuck, you're making me think. Yeah, April 2015. For the S6 and the S6 Edge. Fuck, that's... Yeah.
I'm just trying to look it up now.
Yeah, I'm on Wikipedia. First release,
yeah.
10th of April,
Unveiled on March 1st, 2015. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Well, I wasn't far out. Come on. But still, it's not that bloody old, really. Considering I bought it, it was about 3 years ago I bought it. And back then it was like $1,000 still. So I've made a vow, I'm never going to pay $1,000 for a friggin' phone again when it's only going to last me a couple of years.
So, Oppo and that from...
From good Korea guys, and that. Yeah.
Those seem to get good reviews and shit. Samsung do
yeah, they do cheaper phones as well. The
they do cheaper cut down versions of their flagships.
Yeah, yeah. What are they? The A series or something they're called?
Oh no, I'm not talking about those.
Oh, okay.
No.
But anyway, yeah, I went to the Good Guys and they had cheaper versions of their flagship phones there.
I went from an iPhone 6 to an iPhone fucking XS. So when was the iPhone 6 released? Because I bought that when I got first release.
I've never had an iPhone. I think they're underpowered and overpriced.
I think the opposite. Because I wanted to get an S10, whatever it is, when I was looking at phones, and I'm looking at performance reviews, and I'm like, the iPhone 7 outperforms the S10. It's like, so I'm like, almost 2014, yeah, Jesus Christ.
Anyway, guys, good evening. As interesting as this conversation is, I'm going to head to bed.
See you later. Right?
See ya.
See ya, Acton. Yeah, I've got a Motorola G9 Plus now.
Went from trying to think what I had before. It was an old Sony Ericsson phone with an old keyboard on it. I used to flip out.
Right.
Then I went from one of those to a Nokia N97, same kind of thing. Thick ass phone, you flip it in half and it had a keyboard layout on it.
Yeah.
Ericsson years ago as well. Like, the Ericssons I actually liked. They were a pretty good phone, I thought.
They were great.
The one I had?
Because that we did a lot of traveling and shit, the N97, right, it had a broadcaster in it. For your radio and shit, so you can copy music to it and you can stream it. You just tune your radio and your car to it.
Oh, yeah.
It's like a little niche going around at the time.
The Ericsson I had that for like 5 years, but the bloody thing was like 15 years old and it was still going strong.
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, you just put a killer.
It did have Symbian on it. Yeah, Symbian,
You remember. The old brick phones back like 20 years ago? The old analog ones?
5110s.
What was the one
Nokia I had? Nokia 5110.
Yeah, that might be the one, yeah.
Yeah, I had several of those. I broke several of them.
Oh, did you?
The ones after it. Yeah, when they say they're indestructible, I proved them wrong several times.
Not the 5510. 5510, that was like a tiny little screen in the middle and you had your keyboards on your left and right.
What'd you do? Put a hammer to it or something?
Drop them off balconies.
Oh, okay.
Having it in the pocket, tripping upstairs. Broke a few of them.
I think it was a Nokia 4400 or something. Yeah.
The one I had, I threw it a few times and, yeah, never broke on me.
I even had a dock in my car, my first car, that could have it in there for your hands free and charging and all that.
Okay.
Mine got run over by a school bus and still kind of worked, so... Kind of crushed a little bit.
Yeah, used to get them off dad, the old work phones. And so you had like a box of them, so yeah, you break bits on it and you just grab another one, strip it down, rebuild it. So yeah, tough little phones. They'll make one. Yeah, like text with one hand without even looking at the thing. Now the touchscreen smartphones, yeah, I struggle. What is misspelling shit?
Yeah, I like playing games and shit and watching like just media fucking stuff on my phone. So I went with a bigger screen, though, the 10S Max, which I can kind of use one hand, but it's more comfortable just to use two hands, two fingers when I'm typing. Type really fast. It's same kind of thing when you're two hands on your keyboard. That's what those two little things are on your keyboard, those two little lines on F and J.
Yeah. Yeah, your center lines for your hand.
Yeah. But yeah, I didn't know I can use EDSM to track people who are in your friends list in ADA. In Elite Dangerous, sorry.
Yeah, they're using it as well. Yeah, you can find it.
Yeah,
few more jumps and I should take those bins up. Very dark as shit outside.
Well, you got a long driveway or something, have you?
Yeah.
You out bush?
Yep, 5.5 acres.
Nice.
Man, if the internet went so shit in places were out there, then it's, yeah, I'll do the same thing.
Oh yeah, it took us, well, basically we never had proper internet until NBN came out.
So what are you on, fixed wireless or satellite?
No, copper.
Oh, okay.
It's probably fibre to the node copper to the house.
Yep.
And it depends on how old the property is and how old the copper is.
It's about 40 years old.
Yeah.
Since we've been here, I'd be more than 40 years old now. So we've been on this block 32 years.
So my mate, he lives out at North Dandalup, and he wanted to get, what is it, fiber? Put in. Can't even get fiber out there yet.
Oh, jeez.
They haven't. It's all copper out there, and you can't even get the NBN. So it's like wireless, the fixed wireless.
Yeah.
And complain about your internet, Squire.
Yeah.
His is just dog shit.
What's he on again?
Fixed wireless. So he's
so
on the
NBN,
fast.
Is it?
Yeah, fixed wireless NBN, yeah.
Yeah, that's what mine is. And it's shit.
Yeah, it pays for the fastest speed, doesn't get it, and they give him a discount.
He's lucky. I just changed providers on Saturday to Aussie Broadband from Activate. And I have seen a bit of an improvement on my speeds, but yeah, as soon as the system gets underlay from other users, it just goes to shit again.
Yeah, which is normal for all fixed wireless.
Yeah, fucking terrible. But yet, when I go over to my brother's place, which he lives around the corner from me, around the same time when the system's underlayed, he still gets bloody good speeds.
But is he connected to the same tower?
Yeah. So it's got me stuffed while he's getting good speeds and I'm getting shit speeds.
Well, if you don't know if he's connected to the same tower, then it could be a balancing
thing. Oh, we all
thing.
Are. we're all in this town. We're all connected to the same tower because that's the only tower we've got, Randy.
Well, if you're all on the same plan and everything, then yeah, it should be balancing.
Okay.
Distance usually from the dish to the tower.
Hey.
Yeah, could be a different distance.
I'm a little bit closer than what he is. So, we're actually defying all laws of physics here. Like,
could be something in the way, a tree, building.
Well, everything.
Because if he's got direct line of sight and you don't, yeah, that'll cause issues.
Well, yeah, that's the thing though. We've both got things in the line of sight that's blocking the view, like. But yet he still manages to get like 60 to 70 meg download, and I'm barely able to get like 50 since I've changed over to Aussie broadband. So, yeah, I don't know. I'm just over it now. I just don't give a shit anymore.
Actually, haven't done a speed test in a while.
I was actually sitting here thinking last night, if it wasn't for Elite Dangerous, I'd probably ring him up and tell him just to disconnect him and be done with it.
I might have to restart my access points. I'm not even getting 100 megabits. Oh, it's painful.
Oh, that's a bright one.
So every couple of months I have to do a it's like a scan of the area to see what people's access points are, what wavelengths and shit, their frequencies and shit they're using, so I can tune my bridge to a channel they're not fucking using. But most modems and shit these, they set it to auto, so they bounce around, which fucking pisses me off.
Are you talking about the static IP or?
No, the actual what band they're using, what channel they're using on the.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah. Because I have a, so the house has the copper and shit, not copper, the fiber to the node, then fiber to the house, but to get it to where I am, I have to use a wireless bridge.
Okay.
It, to be honest, it would have been cheaper just digging up the ground and running a cable, but that seemed like too much work, so I just spent like a couple hundred dollars more and got this, top of line fucking... fucking gear.
So you cut your own throat.
Some Ethernet.
Yeah, that would have done the job.
So you cut your own throat in the end, did you?
Kind of, yeah. Oh, it does alright. Then once in a while, it will just turn the dog shit.
Yeah.
That's because more and more people are signing up to the NBN, so there's more interference around.
Yeah.
So literally I have to go to the main AP up the house, do a scan of what that picks it up, and change my frequency.
Okay.
So I'm not running on the same band as them, so I don't get any interference.
Yeah. So what sort of space do you get on your service?
I'll be back in a sec. Take a spin up.
Maximum, so 100 by 40.
Oh, wow. That'd be nice.
So usually my download speed's like 12 or 13 meg down, and...
Yeah.
And up is usually between 3 and 4. Upload's pretty shit.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter what you're on. But download speed, that's... I what is this peak and off-peak time? I don't get any of that shit, so...
Yeah.
Well, majority of people do. Don't get me wrong, majority of people do get it, on even on direct connection to your house. Whoa, why is it running so high?
When I very first got the fixed wireless on, the contract the NBN had with the government back then was 50 down, 20 up. And that was actually really good because I was getting like 40.
That's what I'm getting now. I'm getting 50, 55 down. I'm doing a speed test between the two access points.
Yeah.
So it looks like I'm going to have to reboot them because they have been running
for quite a while without a reboot.
Without a reboot, whereas the uptime, 36 days.
Oh, wow.
Which is not really a long time. Before that, like 3 months.
Shit.
But now I shouldn't see any downtime because I got a UPS down here and I got a UPS up the house, so
no.
There shouldn't be any downtime. The UPS up the house is just for the modem and access point and the phones, so it literally should last the entire fucking day.
Yeah.
Weird that I'm getting such shit speeds.
Yeah, so when I first got the NBN on, I was actually getting pretty close to the 50-20 speeds. It was like 5 megabyte difference between what they said I would get and what I was actually getting. Which was actually good because I could upload a bloody 30 gigabyte bloody video to YouTube in like a couple of hours sort of thing. Then they changed it to 60 down, 5 up. Then they changed it again to 70 down, 10 up or something. And yeah.
All right.
So
just gonna switch it over to auto and see what it does. Automatic power control. Because at the moment these access points are actually too strong.
Oh, okay.
So I've got the output power set to zero and they're still too strong. quite literally, I can take the antenna bit off and it'll be still too strong. Alright, it might lose me if I do this.
If you disappear, I'll know why.
Yeah, it's...
You still there?
That was quick.
I thought I lost you there for a minute. I could still see you in the channel, but I thought I lost you.
No, you did.
Oh, I did it. Okay.
That didn't even fucking reboot. It only changed the channel. Try a speed test. Run again. That's still running like dog shit. What the fuck? It's given me a warning. CPU usage has been over 90% for... Oh my god, what the fuck is going on with it? We quit out of a lead. You go. I'm gonna reset both of them. So you're gonna lose me for about 5 minutes.
Yep.
See if I do a full reboot off of both of them, and yeah, hopefully it
settles down a bit.
I forgot how to restart them. I think this is the button. Yep. Yeah, that was quick.
Did you get it sorted?
I'm doing a speed test now between the link.
Okay.
Test failed, so probably not.
No. Gotta love to hate technology, don't we?
Yeah. I know I should be getting faster speeds than these, but I'm actually doing a speed test. This is the actual Telstra modem.
Oh, okay. Geez, I haven't been with Telstra for a couple of years now. Okay, then the flick.
Why isn't my dot working?
Your what?
The dot between 0 and enter on the numpad.
Yeah.
Just gonna rip it off.
You got number lock on, obviously.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because the actual numbers are working.
Oh. Just
weird.
I just thought I'd mention it because there's been a couple of times where I've accidentally hit the number lock button to turn off the keypad. And I'm trying to press the buttons on the number keypad and they're not working. I'm like, why the fuck aren't they working? Because you've hit the button, dumbass.
Oh, I don't know why the fuck this is not working.
Finding a shitload of water worlds, Eddie. Found about 5 or 6 tonight now.
Nice.
Welcome back. Oh wow, cool.
What'd you find?
Just another water world. But no, I was just looking at the galaxy and I was expecting that I wouldn't even be near halfway across the normal arm yet, but I am. Almost. Almost halfway across it.
Yeah, you'll get there.
I'm just looking at the time, it's 2 o'clock in the morning, and I'm thinking I don't want to go to bed yet.
Ah, oh, for fuck's sake.
I want to keep going all night tonight and just get back to the bubble.
Some reason the output's what the fuck is going on?
Oh, with your switch?
Hmm? Oh, the access point up the house. I don't know what the fuck is going. It should be set to auto, but it's not set to auto. Fuck, I'll do it from the web browser. What do we got? Signal is too strong, oversaturation. Well, I know, nothing I can do about it. Ah, it's probably why it's being shit, because it's doing an auto scan. Because I've set it to auto, what it will do is it will scan the immediate area and automatically adjust.
Okay.
For each connected device?
The channel. No, this is on the main link between the house and the shed.
Yeah.
So we'll look around for anyone else's access points and kind of avoid them like the plague. Okay, apparently I'm getting max. So it must be the modem then.
Need a reset?
Yeah, it's not getting max speed. It's bouncing around. But the link between the house and shit should be fine.
Seeing I haven't reset my modem pretty much since the they had to fix the line.
And my stupid dot on the fucking keyboard is not working. Why the fuck not? Let me just unplug it and plug it back in.
Yeah, I got a keyboard I need to repair at some point. See if I can replace the switches on it.
Do I have a dot now? What if a dot? It was fucking working like 2 seconds ago.
Yeah, I got a string of keys that don't work on my other one. So that's the question mark, Windows keys completely missing and a couple others. Where it's kind of met the desk.
The funny thing is all the keys around it are working.
Hmm.
I might have to reboot my computer. Nope, now it's working. That's why it wasn't working. I had hardware info open, so it must be using it for one of its key bindings for a test or something.
Okay.
Possibly. Hotkey set to no. Ah, there you go. Yeah, it was. There we go. Turn it off. And there's just going to be a whole bunch of logs in there now. Sitting there trying to use it and it's not working. I'm like, yep, because I've actually set it up as a key binding for something else.
Start and...
Logging and shit, yeah. Logging the CPU and shit. For frequencies, voltages, best cores, yeah. It's weird, I'm not hitting the 5 gigahertz today. 4.8 is the maximum it got up to. At 100% load, it can hold 4.7, 4.6.
Not bad.
Yeah, and in spikes, I'm meant to be able to get it up to about 5 gigahertz. It's just finding out the right cores and shit to push harder. But it looks like I've been shivved again by the silicon lottery.
Yeah, we haven't had much luck with that lately.
Nope.
I think I did pretty alright with my current one. I know my old one's bloody good. Did well on that one.
We get yours easily up to... You're using like a 10500K, aren't you?
Yeah, the
10600? Is it 10600? It's a 10600. Yeah, 10600K is the i5.
Yeah, that'll be the one.
Apparently you can get a better overclock than the 10900K on your CPU. Better, yeah.
Pretty much why I went the i5 variant.
Shouldn't be overclocking yet anyway, but yeah.
Yeah, because base speed's 4.10.
No.
No.
10600K. That doesn't sound right.
I'm just looking in the performance tab task.
Yep. Sorry, base is 4.1, overclock is 4.8. Yep.
Okay, so I'll probably get more out of it then.
Right, should be all set to auto and in the BIOS.
Is there anything I'm changing the BIOS is XMP?
Undervolt. Oh yeah, so you can undervolt it and get 100 ma- That's overvolt. 100 millivolts. Wow, this is different than AMD. At 1.25 to 1.3 volts, and try and get 5 gigahertz stable on all cores.
Yay! Another water world. Woohoo.
Yeah, I've been drowning in them.
Nice little pun there.
I was pretty happy to finally find some of those Earth-likes earlier. A pair of them right next to each other.
Oh, okay. Nice.
Considering the system before, it was the mark was like right on the line, like, oh, is it going to be an Earth-like or a rocky world? And then it was a fucking rocky world.
Yeah.
And the very next system I jumped into, it was here, two Earth-likes.
Nice.
Both orbiting each other.
I think I found a Earth-like orbiting a water world on the other side of the galaxy.
Yeah, I've found a few of those out that way.
You're going to lose me for about 5 minutes.
Yep, yeah. Too easy.
Yeah, so that was a nice little surprise, that one.
Hmm.
And why hasn't it died yet?
Wait, internet?
Yeah, come on.
You have entered the Twilight Zone. There he goes.
Yep, finally.
Delayed reaction.
That was the other thing I was going to do this week. Wipe my computer and start again. Not going to have time now. That'll be a next week job.
Oh, okay.
Or weekend job when I'm back.
Oh, I hate formatting.
Come back.
Yeah. Oh, I hate formatting computers. It's...
The only annoying part is the programs. All my data's backed up through the cloud.
Yeah.
Using OneDrive, which is fucking handy because all I got to do is reload Windows, like wipe everything, reload Windows, put in your Microsoft account, and it goes, hey, I know you. Dumps it all back where it should be.
Oh, okay.
So I ended up paying, because I was using Dropbox for a long time and paying for that each year. And then for work stuff, I needed a more current version of Excel. Like Word was fine, but it was mainly Excel because none of the macros were working for some of my spreadsheets. And using the online ones, which were very limited to file size. So then I end up going, okay, what's the price for... like buying the Microsoft pack, and I was like, oh, it comes with a terabyte of OneDrive. I'm paying for a terabyte of Dropbox. So like, well, once the Dropbox thing expires, then I'll just buy the other one. I'm getting all the whole Microsoft suite with it as well.
Yeah.
And then did the couple formats since then, and had everything backed up to it. And it's like, oh my god, this is so much easier than it used to be, where I'd have to plug in an external hard drive, copy everything on, do the wipes, reinstalls, and then copy everything back over.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to sit there and do a program list.
So does it automatically remember where you're uploading files from on your computer, does it?
Yeah, so you just select what folders you want to sync, and then basically it syncs it between the your PC and the cloud, and I've got my old PC set up with a fresh install of Windows, and in any time I can just drop those files in from the cloud.
Yeah.
So I can essentially, like, if this computer completely shut itself, I can just boot that one up and bring everything straight across.
Oh, okay. When I formatted my computer there a couple of weeks ago, I had it all set up to the point where I was able to get to desktop, and as I was starting to reinstall everything, I noticed that the user folder was named differently to what I had it before I formatted the computer. So instead of having my name there, it had I think it had the first three initials of the first three letters of my name, and that was it. And okay. I'm thinking, so when I get it back, you know, restore everything from my backups and that, it's going to cause problems. So I had to reformat again, but I worked out what it was. So when I formatted the computer and I signed into my Windows account, it created the user folder based on the first three letters of my Microsoft account.
Okay.
Yeah, so I was looking into all that when I formatted the computer again, because I thought that's not right. So when I found that out, I reformatted the computer and went through it all again. But this time I didn't sign into my Microsoft account until I actually started installing all my other software and that, so it actually stayed as the username that I wanted to create, which was basically my name. So
I should be able to at any point go into the users and change the name.
There is a workaround to do it, but for some reason it wasn't working for me. So to do it, they say you got to do it through the regedit files and all that. So I did all that, and it still wasn't working for me.
Yeah, careful with messing with that sort of
stuff. Yeah, I don't like it.
End up in my position.
What are you playing with the regedit?
No, I was just talking about when I formatted my computer there a couple of weeks ago. When I formatted my computer, I signed into my Microsoft account and I created my user folder name from the first three letters of my name rather than actually my name. And so I had to reformat my computer to get it to recognize my full name, but not sign into my Microsoft account until I actually had everything set up the way I wanted it. Before I formatted the second time, I was trying to problem solve it so I didn't have to format again. Everything I tried, it wasn't working, so I just stuff it, then I'll reformat again. Luckily, I didn't get too far into it, sort of thing, you know. I would have been spewing if I hadn't have picked up on it straight away. And I had left it for, say, a week or something, and I'd already restored, you know, most of my computer, sort of thing. So
if I go on my phone, I get my full speed.
It's just the PC.
I don't know what the fuck's going on. You might lose me you're definitely going to lose me. I'm just going to switch
ports. Well, then that new driver?
I'm not even using it in the real tech.
Yeah, because I couldn't even get mine to install it because the other one still failing and it won't let me install the optionals.
The new real tech driver. I just went to Gigabyte. That were using it, the same chip as ours, but it had a newer version. So I just downloaded it from there and installed that.
Oh, okay.
Because all it is just a they have their own tweaks and shit they've done to the try and get it working. It's just MSI hasn't updated it yet.
Yeah.
I wanted to see if theirs worked and it was still having issues. So just let me change ports.
It wasn't a water world that I found. It was a gas giant. It was right on the border.
Hopefully this fucking works this time.
Bloody hell.
This is my network switch. It is pushing like 10 years old, so... Oh yeah, look at that. Look at that speed.
Yeah, yeah, go on. Rub it in.
Same in the other ports?
Yeah, just... It could have been a shit connection, but yeah. It's not the fastest I've seen it. But it, I'm definitely getting my ride speed. Upload, I'm not.
I'll tell my brother I'm going to run an Ethernet cable from his house to my house.
Remember, you only can go, 100 meters with Ethernet? So yeah. You would need to put a switch, you would need to put a powered switch in every 100 meters.
Yeah, I'll probably need a couple of them. He's like, between 200 and 300 meters away.
I'm looking at a 10 gigawatt switch at the moment. $749. I don't even have 10 gigawatt.
Far out.
That's cheap, by the way. That's really, really cheap.
Really?
For a 10 gigabit Ethernet switch, yes.
You know what I wouldn't mind having? Google's bloody gigabit connection.
Can't get it here in Australia.
No, I think they're only installing it in America at the moment. I've been hearing stories, people are getting like, 5 millisecond pings and, they're getting nearly a bloody gigabyte download speeds. Like, what the hell?
Yeah, I get, if I'm playing with a friend if I'm hosting the game, so it's like a direct connection from my house to my friend's house, like 30 kilometers away, I get like 4 or 5, probably 6 millisecond ping between and him.
But who knows?
Sorry. Who needs it? A lot of people.
A 1,000 gigabyte download speed? Come on. That's overkill.
Yeah.
No. I mean, I'd like to have it, so don't get me wrong when I say...
What I want is 100 by 100. That's what I fucking want. Because 100 by 40 is... The 40 up is okay for most people, but for what I'm doing, it's not.
I'd be happy with 50-20 again.
I'm just over slow upload speed.
Yeah, that's what stopped me from playing a lot of on games for a long time.
What's pissing me off with the fixed wireless is they're trying to make out that everyone wants download speed, and I'm trying to tell them, well, no, some of us actually want upload speed as well. So stop thinking about bloody download speed and how about splitting it. So instead of making it bloody 70 down and 10 up, make it more like 50 down and 30 up or something, split it.
So the funny thing is, if I wanted to switch to Aussie broadband, it's actually cheaper for me to stay on Telstra. It's more expensive on Aussie broadband for my current plan anyway.
What plan are you on?
100 by 40. But I'm on an old legacy plan, so when they first put in the,
Okay.
So what they're doing at the time for people to say sign up is giving away the 100 by 40 speed boost, because you got to pay, like, an extra, was it 10, 15 bucks for the speed a month?
You know, with Aussie Broadband, that they have plans where you get unlimited data, but you also get,
$109, then you got to pay for your phone on top of that as well, so it's... $119 a month.
Far out.
For Aussie Broadband, that's with unlimited data, and
I'm paying,
and you just every day for local national calls.
Okay, I'm paying. I think it's $80 a month for my plan. But there's no speed restrictions though either. That's what I was going to say to you. Maybe they've changed it where you don't get speed restricted anymore.
So about $160 for the NBN Ultra Fastnet plan. Wow. Which is as fast as your connection can handle.
Yeah, okay.
It's per month, eh?
That is per month.
Yeah.
It's $149 if you want just data.
And from what I've read about Starlink, that they charge about $150 a month.
That's only in beta.
Yeah, I know, but yeah, $150 a month.
I don't think it's in beta in Australia yet to the public.
No, they're still working on it, from what I've read.
Anyway. I did hear something recently about it.
Yeah, I was reading in the article about it, and they're still. I think they're still trying to iron out a contract with the government or something to get a like testing. You know, get testing available.
Because we're buttfuck places in Australia, just the middle of Australia and shit, and goldfields and that. All you'll have is satellite, which is fucking shit.
Yeah.
Well, I'm gonna go watch some stuff. Go to bed.
Easy.
Catch us tomorrow.
Shall we? Hey, catch up. Yeah, my download speed's not too bad at the moment. 53 down. Upload's a bit shitty. Could be because I'm gaming.
What what space are you supposed to be getting?
I think it's 50 down and 20 up.
Oh, okay.
But upload is never quite there. But download, we're actually getting, I guess, slightly over what we're paying.
Oh, okay. That's the same thing with me brother. He's paying for 70 down, 10 up. But yet he's getting like 60 down, 55 down sort of thing. But he's getting like 13 up. But how does that... how does that work? It
comes down to line attenuation.
I'm just wondering if it's because he's got new, all new gear as well, like new cables.
That as well.
New dish, new NBN box. My gear is like 3 years old now.
Yeah, so we're on, as of a few months ago, on a new modem from Telstra, and yeah, it's definitely a big difference between the old one and the new one.
Yeah.
The old one was split, so you had the 2.8 gigahertz and the 5 gigahertz, which now it's just a 5 gigahertz.
Oh, okay.
And it's, yeah, even with the long distance stuff, the speeds are actually a lot better than the previous one. So if I was on Wi-Fi in my room and the modem's on the other side of the house, I would be getting only a couple bars of signal with the 5 gigahertz, but where you're 2.8, it's a more of a lower frequency, so it travels further.
Oh, okay.
And I'd get full frequency. It's like with audio, your high-end and your bass always travels further because it's a lower signal.
Yeah.
Less waves in the line.
Yep. I like my bass.
I haven't played mine for a while. I actually kind of lost the calluses on my fingers. I haven't played that long. Which is really bad for me. I'm a fucking musician. It was September last time I played it.
Oh, okay. You should be practicing each day sort of thing.
Well, I've taken one out of its case since the last show we played. I haven't even reset my amp up.
Oh, okay.
When I built this computer, I got all the interface and that sitting there, but I haven't even plugged it in. I haven't even put the drivers or anything on for it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've been lazy. But I did speak to the guitarist briefly today. I got a fucking phone call when it was on Friday from the tax department. Apparently we haven't put a tax return in. I'm like, oops. it was a private number calling me. I'm like, oh, it might be a work thing, so I answered it. And it's like, oh yeah, I've been trying to get in contact with you guys for a while. And like, oh shit, okay, that's why they're calling on a private number. They can't get through to you on the normal channels and that, they'll start ringing other people on private numbers hoping to catch you.
Oh, okay.
Just in case you're trying to dodge them.
Yeah.
And it's like, we've been pretty much inactive. And it's like, yeah, no, that's fine because of all COVID and that. And because I explained, we're musicians and with COVID, like, entertainment industries, fucking nothing's going on. So, we don't make money anyway, but we still got to do tax returns.
Yeah.
And it's like, even if you haven't done anything, you just need to put a tax return in for zero. I'm like, yep, too easy. I'll get in contact with the guys.
Oh, okay.
They just like their paperwork in order, pretty much. So we're gonna set up as a partnership kind of thing. They kind of have to.
I have my phone set to automatically block private numbers.
Oh, even if it's like robocalls, I still answer the call, and it's always nice when you get a human and you can fuck with them.
That's why I don't answer them, because a couple of years ago, I changed my phone number about 3 times in 1 year. Because I kept getting those bloody robo dollars calling me from overseas. Yep. And at first I didn't know, I always realised that there was like a couple of second delay between me saying hello and before someone actually picked up the phone and started talking to me.
Yeah, because it's an audio cue.
Yeah.
And, otherwise it will hang up and dial the next number if they don't get a response.
Yeah, and as soon as I picked up the phone, though, it was basically telling them, this is an active number, we'll keep handing them now. And that's exactly what happened to me.
Calls all the time, they're usually from Victoria. So
really?
There's a place in Victoria where they're all scam calls. I get one saying, tax department's coming after me and all of that, and which is absolute bullshit, because if you were in that sort of circumstance where, they're chasing you, you'd be getting letters in the mail.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
And it'd be an actual person calling you, not a robo voice. Occasionally you get the ones from Apple and stuff saying a charge has been made to your account and stuff. Like, I don't even own any Apple products, so fuck off. They wouldn't own Apple products willingly. I've had a few iPhones, but they're all been hand-me-downs.
Yeah.
I ain't paying for that overpriced shit that basically restricted to what you can put it on there and pull off.
I'm the same way when it comes to Apple. The only Apple product I've ever actually bought is an iPod. And when I bought it, I realised I could have just bought a friggin' USB.
I used my Samsung for it, put a terabyte SSD in it. Fucking micro SD.
Yeah.
And I just keep putting music on, and I've had it for, 3 years. Keep putting music on, and it's still not full.
Okay. Yeah, all my robo callers were coming from overseas, but they were disguising their number as New South Wales calls. I realised that it was, they're disguising the number, because as soon as I called the number back, it would say, this number is not connected, please check the number and try again.
Yeah, because it's a legit number, but it's done through a web app, basically. We use similar things that work for a lot of our automated calls and text messaging. And it comes from the server, but it's a legit number. And what they do a lot of the times, they buy up old numbers and put them into their systems. So they got like dozens and dozens of them. And with the more modern phones, it'll actually display when the caller is calling you, it will say potential fraud or scam, because other people have reported that number through the phone, and then it goes into the server, whatever. So when it calls you, it comes up saying potential fraud or scam caller. So whenever I get them, I do the same thing. I can report it, block the number, and then now and then I'll go reverse number search on the computer, and it'll tell you exactly where the number's located, and it's always in a like a building somewhere in Victoria. And then you'll see a log of people who have also like commented, say, it's a scam caller, and what they're basically trying to chase you for. And say, it's all fraud. And it's gotten worse during COVID, because more people at home, and more people are so savvy with tech. When you're getting someone calling you saying, oh, you owe us money for this or that, they're going to go, okay, what the fuck, or we need your account details to do this or whatever, and then they go hand over the fucking credit card numbers like you idiots.
Not thinking.
They target a lot of elderly, things like that. They just don't know, because they haven't been around this sort of tech. It's all only in the last 20 years this shit's come about.
Well, speaking of scammers, my brother was just telling me the other night that mum was telling him that she got an email from PayPal saying that she needs to update her payment details with some company. And she was saying she's never even signed up to this company or something, and she's she doesn't know what they're on about. And David's going, if you don't know what it's on about, it's a scam. So just delete the email and forget about it.
Yeah, I don't really get the PayPal ones. I get Apple ones now and then. Basically, an invoice for some Apple product. And then, because the email address they disguise as, like, apple.com or whatever. But then if you actually click on it, it's a jumbled mash of letters.
Yeah.
Like, that's not a real email address.
No. And the other way, too, with big companies like PayPal, they use your first name, especially if you're signed up with them.
Yeah.
And if you're still not sure, you just like, go straight to their website if you've got an account, too.
Yeah, and the thing with PayPal is you set up your three-factor authentication, so they need obviously your number and stuff. They'll send you an email with the verification code, and they'll text you a verification code.
Yeah.
And that way, they can't hack it, because unless they actually physically have your phone, they can't do shit.
So, I've had a couple
something
of scams
like that years ago. Facebook got hacked, and whoever hacked it like basically cleared out most of my contacts. So I'm like, what the fuck? Why would you do that? And found out, it was some login from over in Sydney. I'm like, I'm in Western Australia, so what the fuck? And then saw that, you can set up the two-factor authentication, so I set that up, never had a problem since.
I've had emails from fake PayPal. I've had a phone call from PayPal. Called me on the number, right? And I didn't recognise the number, so I didn't answer it. And when when it finished ringing out, I hid my phone number by default, and then I called the number back. They've answered, and I'm like, I've just had a missed phone call. And they're like, can I get your details, please? And I'm like, who are you, sorry? And they're like, PayPal. And I'm like, how do I know you're PayPal? We're PayPal. And I'm like, well, I'm sorry, but PayPal doesn't call people unless you call them. And they hung up. So I called them back again. And I said to them, why are you trying to scam people saying you're PayPal? We are PayPal. I'm like, no, you're not. You're just scamming people because PayPal will only call you if you call them or you send them an email. So they hung up again. So I called them back again and I said, stop scamming people. They hung up again. years ago, going back, 15 years ago now, I had a phone call from someone claiming to be Microsoft. We're calling up to help you with your computer. You reported the computer issue. I didn't report no computer issue. Yes, you did. No, I didn't.
I don't have a computer.
I did have one at the time, but yeah, I don't recall reporting an issue with it though. And that's what I said to her, and yeah. So, been a couple of times that people have tried to scam me.
Stellar Phenomena.
The ones I feel sorry for are these bloody scammers that go to door to door. We'll fix your roof for you and this and that, and they lose thousands of dollars to con men. Traveling con men, they're called, or something.
Now, what am I scanning here? Oh, that might be there. Or is that a rock? That's a rock. It's got the metallic ball thingies and the spiky things. Was a life form one I needed? A bit harder to find when they're in rings.
Did you all the way over there now?
Yeah.
Where is it? Scalday or something that's called?
The system?
Yeah, SKAUDAI, is that it?
Yeah.
So you've come over towards me and now you've gone back the other way again.
That's what a fully engineered condo can do.
Wow. Where am I?
An Albulus Bell Mollusk.
I'm about halfway across Norma Arm there.
Give it a scan. Flash the lights at it. Boop it, make it make noises. I think it reacts to light. Four,
the noises they make.
Little whales. Leave me alone. You been mean to him?
No. Cool. Now back to the carrier. How far is that? Kind of worries me when you see the carrier's over there. My ships look like they're there.
So where's your carrier?
A few jumps away. Jumps. 16 jumps. That should be most of my codex stuff now. Oh, that's right. In the multi-crew. Bad crew. Session report. View report. Almost 5,000 light years.
That's how far your carrier is?
No, when Stick was multi-crewed to me.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, almost 5,000 light years in an hour and a half.
Wow.
Not bad.
Jeez, it'll take me friggin' hours to do that in this shit ape.
When you get back to the bubble, we'll help you with some engineering.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to get into that, I think.
Oh, it's well worth it.
I feel like I'm flying a bucket of bolts out of here.
Well, first big trip I did out in the black, my ship wasn't that well engineered.
Yeah.
Second one, it was a bit better engineered, and now this one, yeah, basically you got the ship at its peak.
Yeah.
I don't think I'd do exploring in any other ship than this Condo.
Just pop the cans, did you?
Sorry?
Did you just pop a can?
No. Still in main one. Just loaded up the second one to start the bubble on.
Huh.
Multitasking.
Oh, okay. So where'd you get the name for your other account?
Nariko Musashi.
Yeah.
Noriko, when I was growing up, like, I think it was like 2, she was a girl that lived at my nan's place,
yeah, you had a little crush on her, did you?
No, I don't even remember her.
Oh.
I was 2. She was a student that, like, my nan used to have, students from, like, China and, Japan come over and basically would board at her house.
Yeah.
And apparently she used to, like, wake up super early in the morning, get on a bike, ride down towards the city, go to the local fish markets, buy a massive fish, chuck it in a backpack, go to school for the day, then come home and cook said fish that had been sitting in a backpack all day. And when she came back to the house, I used to get a, ox crate or something, put it next to the stove, and while she was cooking, she'd feed me all this random shit. And Mum's like, yeah, I never knew what you were eating, because you was just basically standing there open mouth and she'd feed you. That's probably why I eat just about everything now.
Okay.
And it's just a name that's always kind of just stuck around.
Yeah.
Musashi, Japanese name, so I just put the two together.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I kind of imagine me eating the piece of fish that's been in someone's backpack all day.
Well, as my mum puts it, yeah, it was this fish that was in a backpack all day, and then she would get the smallest fry pan and cook the fish, which was that hanging out at the sides.
That's funny.
Yeah, she's from like rural China or something, so it's just, that's what you did. You didn't have refrigeration.
Yeah, that. I actually feel sorry for the Chinese with the way they've been forced to live over the years. Bloody communism. Worst bloody thing for any nation, I think.
Well, even theirs is not true communism. It's a mixture of that and capitalism.
What's that, sorry?
Mixture of communism and capitalism.
China?
Hmm.
That's not what they call the CCP. System scan complete. CCP stands for, what is it, communism?
Yeah. No, it is very heavily communist, but at the same time, it's got a huge influence of
capitalism. Yeah.
And you get the Americans to thank for that.
In a way, any politician's sort of a capitalist, in a way, because they're all out to make money, aren't they?
Oh, why else would you be in the job?
Exactly. Yeah, I just think any form of communism's not good for a nation, though. Because it's essentially being a dictator, really.
Oh, yeah, it comes with the territory.
Hey?
Comes with the territory.
Yeah, exactly. It's the same with... what's the other one that's close to it? Socialism? Is that the one I'm thinking of?
Yeah.
But anyway, we're getting political here. So I've actually travelled a fair distance tonight so far. I've travelled nearly 3,000 light years tonight.
Yeah, I've done quite a big loop.
Sorry?
I've done quite a big loop.
Yeah, rub it in. Where are you, Danny?
Yes, we have had a tick. The system just hasn't moved.
You're about 8,000 light years from me. Oh, you just moved. Where'd you go? Oh, you're over there now.
Apparently I'm just over 11,000 light years from Kati. It says one of my voice packs.
Cool.
That's 56 as well. Yep, so we definitely have had a tick that's gone up. No, hang on. Was it the wrong system? Don't call my fucking carpet cat. Night jumps on the carrier. Cool, but it's timed up pretty well. Jump on one computer, scoop with the other, and vice versa. So that's jumping, throttle back.
You think I'll be able to play Elite Dangerous on the one computer?
Possibly, but your computer might struggle a bit. They've got to be, because you've got the Steam version and the
Epic version. Epic. Yeah,
so you got essentially two different launches, so that's possible. Where with me, because they're both Steam versions, it doesn't work.
Oh, okay.
Because you're going to run one at a time.
Yep. I guess I'll put it in trial, couldn't I?
It's just the strain on the hardware.
And yeah.
What you told me, you're running pretty old stuff, so it probably won't run as well.
It's just the motherboard and the CPU. Sorry?
What CPU do you have?
So I've got the Asus Maximus 5 Extreme motherboard.
Yeah.
And I've got an Intel i7-3770K overclocked to 4.2 or 4.5 gigabyte. Gigahertz, sorry,
I
mean.
What was it? i7
3770K.
3770K.
Okay. Yeah. At the time when I bought it, it wasn't that old, but yeah, it's outdated now. It's not a bad computer, you know.
4 cores, 8 threads. Yeah, it's not bad. You'd still be struggling.
Yeah.
Boost frequency of 3.90. When did that release? Yeah, and that was a cheap chip too. Wish you for an i7.
What's that?
Oh, it's recommended retail price when it first came out. Fucking cheap compared to what they charge you for these days.
How much was it?
$342.
Yeah, sounds about right. What I paid for it.
Ivy Bridge, what year was that?
It was around 2015 or something, I think. Maybe a bit earlier.
What generation? Third gen, wow. Yeah, so my old build is a 4th gen.
Mm-hmm.
And my current's a 10th gen.
And they still sell them as well.
Oh, okay.
Oh, maybe that was the generation of what my first chip was. I think I might have had the i5 variant prior to my fourth gen. Should dig it out and check what it is. I think it's the same socket, LGA 1155.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're still buying brand new on Amazon.
Okay.
Still in the box. Oh, they didn't do an i9 back then. Huh.
No, he went up to the R7.
Yeah, so it's fourth gen that they changed.
I think the i9s only came out last year, wasn't it?
No, they've been around since fourth gen.
Oh, okay.
Yours is third gen.
Oh, so I just missed it. Jeez, my computer is out of date then.
Not really. It is. Even.
It is like motherboard and CPU wise, but the graphics cards are alright.
Yeah. That's usually what you do. You build a computer and then at some point update the graphics cards. And then.
The CPU.
Build new motherboard, CPU, put that graphics card in until you're ready to put a new graphics card in.
Yeah, keep recycling.
Yeah. So I've done that with about 3 builds now in the last few years.
Oh, okay.
And so my old build is back to all of its original parts in its original box.
Yeah.
Seven jumps. Getting distracted looking at chips.
Sorry.
No, it's all good. Yeah, so I'm pretty sure my first CPU was the i5 of that, but I don't think it was a K.
Yeah.
I think it's the same socket though.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we'll have new motherboards coming out shortly for Intel and the 11th gen chips.
Yeah.
Which are basically just a refresh of the 10th gen.
Yep. Which
is currently running. But apparently my motherboard can host a 11th gen chip.
Oh, okay. If I want to get another chip now, I'll probably have to update my motherboard first.
I'd be wise to do both.
Sorry?
Be wise to do both. Motherboard, CPU and RAM.
Yeah.
You can still use the same graphics card, because you got 10 series, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, which they're still pretty good. Which one do you have?
1080.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, you'd be still pretty alright with most things.
Yeah. Oh, they're pretty good graphics cards, but really, even they're outdated now.
Oh, yeah. I bought my 2080 Ti, and a couple of weeks later, they announced the 30 series.
I was actually a bit disappointed.
That's brand bloody new.
Yeah. I was actually disappointed that they released a 1080. I bought two of them, and then within a year, they're already outdated because they go to the new technology they're using or whatever it is they changed.
Yeah, different CUDA cores and CUDA core amount, different architecture.
Yeah.
I think
going into the what was it?
My 980 Ti's and the 10 series are on Pascal, and then the 20s are on Turing, and I'm not sure what the 30s are on.
Oh, okay.